I built a couple cars for a good customer of ours named Juan Martinez. He came in, he had bought the 69 Mustang, and you know, he wanted to kind of do something for me and my dad to help us get our name out there. He was willing to supply all the parts for the car, so we provided all the labor on the car, a lot of long nights, a lot of sleepless nights, and basically he kind of let me do my design, let me do what I wanted to do to the car, as long as it still looked like a 69 Mustang at the end of the day. We cut the quarter panels off the car. The 69 quarter panels have a little vent on the side of them, so we got rid of those. We took 70 quarter panels and rolled them and made them 2.5 inches wider per side. So the car is actually wider, so we could keep the back seat, but still get that big 345 back tire. The fenders are 1.5 inches wider per side in the front, and the whole front of the car is carbon fiber. We've changed everything on the car except for the roof. Custom made hood, custom rear deck lid. I mean, everything on the car is just, you know, one-off stuff that we worked on. We bought the fenders, they're a production piece from Anvil Auto. The front and rear body kits are from Ring Brothers, which we heavily modified. But it gave us a good foundation to work off of. I called John Cossey, Racing Engines, and I was fascinated with their boss-headed motor. We wanted something that just screamed horsepower. We build drivers, you build cars you want to get out and drive. I wanted to do a 572 Ford. So we put together a combination on bore size. They got me the piston, the heads. We ordered the crank and rods, and I had a place in Houston Engine Balance and in Houston put the motor together. So on the chassis of the car, I had this idea that I didn't want to see any visible nuts on the car. So everything is a button head bolt that screws together. They're file fit to fit the car. Much as I tried to think about the chassis, I wanted to carry that through the interior. So I approached the interior guys and told them that, you know, I don't want to see any stitching in the car. I love the crisp lines and the lot of tucks in the interior, but I didn't want to see the stitching. I didn't like the French seam. It's been done, and I wanted to do something that nobody's seen. And the color is classic Stampede gray. They named the leather after the car, so it's just really good. I had a really good team on board. I'll probably drive it. We plan on taking it to a bunch of Good Guys events and, you know, doing a lot of indoor shows and SEMA, and we want to show the car. We want to show people what we do. We want to show people everything, and, you know, I want to drive it. I want to show that it was built to be driven.
I've always been a Ford guy at heart, had lots of Mustangs when I grew up. This color was the easiest color I've ever made. It's one toner, one pearl, sprayed over a black base coat, and you're done. Three coats, you're done, it matches, and it was almost too easy. Well, the Global 8152 is the best clear I've ever used, and I've used them all. At times, I've used it as a primer, quite honestly, to level out things, block sand it, and apply more. And then when you buff it out, I mean, the results behind you, it's amazing. It buffs easy, and a year later it buffs easy. I'll use it as long as they make it, until they make a better one. I have no other reason to use anything but PPG. It's always done well for me. The support is there when we need it. I'm not gonna cheat on my wife, as it were.